On the Portuguese island of Pico is a massive active volcano which towers often above cloud cover and occasionally has snow on its summit. The volcano in question is the tallest point in all of Portugal and is known as Mount Pico. Despite its vast size, as it stands at 2,351 meters or 7,713 feet above sea level, this volcano is surprisingly young. In fact, the entire volcano with its large summit crater formed completely within the last 10,000 years. Although Mount Pico has not erupted since 1720, it intermittently has an active fumarole on its summit, hinting that the overall volcano is still active. The island of Pico is located in the Azores island chain several hundred kilometers west of mainland Portugal. Mount Pico's edifice represents the youngest phase of volcanic activity on the island, as the island was formed via three separate volcanoes. The Azores island chain exists at an unusual area of the Earth's crust. They are emplaced across the boundaries of three tectonic plates near what is termed a triple junction. In the mantle underlying these three plates is a hotspot termed the Azores Hot Spot, which intermittently supplies molten rock to the surface. The first of a group of volcanoes which formed the island of Pico began erupting approximately 850,000 years ago when a large volume of magma erupted onto the ocean floor. Over the next several tens of thousands of years, continued submarine volcanic eruptions built a towering shield volcano. Eventually, its center broke the surface and began constructing an island which was elongated to the east and west, as this represented an underlying fissure. Over the next 50,000 years, this shield volcano with its large central caldera constructed what is now the eastern half of Pico Island. At some point in its geologic history, a massive eruption occurred, causing the southern half of the caldera to collapse to the side. The remnants of this early shield volcano can be found at the coordinates labeled on screen. Eventually, this shield volcano went extinct as eruptive activity moved away from a central vent and into the surrounding system of fissures. Frequent Strombolian-style eruptions occurred over the next 200,000 years, and eruptions similar to what is ongoing at La Palma, which built several hundred cinder cones. Then, 6,500 years ago, basalt lava unexpectedly erupted onto the surface where it solidified into a single central vent. As the weeks, then months, then years passed, this volcano continuously erupted at a rate similar to that of Mount Etna. It likely erupted for 145 years straight, creating pyroclastic flows and hurling bombs of lava in a several kilometer radius. The explosive component of these eruptions created Mount Pico's summit crater, which is where the majority of explosive activity occurred. Since then, the summit of Pico has not erupted, as instead eruptions occurred on its flanks. The first historical eruption occurred from 1562 to 1564, which sent a long-lived lava flow towards the northern coastline where it constructed a large lava delta. In 1718, another eruption occurred closer to the main summit via a series of cinder cones which created lava flows which reached both the north and south coastlines. A third eruption occurred in 1720, which covered 6 square kilometers in molten rock. On December 15th of 1963, a supposed submarine volcanic eruption was reported off the island's northwestern coastline, but no direct evidence of this eruption has since been found. Despite Mount Pico's history of explosive eruptions, its future eruptions are likely to be less explosive and create groups of cinder cones away from its main edifice. Such cinder cone forming eruptions could technically occur anywhere on the western 3/5 of the island, but are most likely to occur at two trends of activity marked on screen. The main threat from these future eruptions would be long-distance lava flows and associated toxic gases. With this being said, in the event that the summit of Mount Pico was to erupt, all settlements within a 10-kilometer radius would be at risk due to the threat of pyroclastic flows, which could travel unusually long distances due to Pico's steep overall slope. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.